Welcome to Steel's Weekly Hack. This week we're going to talk about the importance of maintaining screening equipment. We don't sell screening equipment, at least we don't sell screening equipment we make, but it's still critical to the overall process of making good extruded products, and so we want to walk through that. As always, you can find our weekly hack info at jcsteel.com/weeklyhack. Or you can send us an email at parts@jcsteel.com if you see something you need or you need more information. We also have information on our LinkedIn page, so feel free to check that out, subscribe, and we'll keep you informed. So, starting right out, while we're going to talk about screening is this control of feedstock. You've heard us talk in the past about the importance of having a good quality feedstock to make good quality product. And here's a picture of the mine. And here's just a picture of some contaminants that are found in that raw material. So we're going to walk through that and how to improve it. And so we've talked about having a scalping screen right out of your grinder or coming out of your jaw crusher. And as you can see here in the left picture, there is some organic material that is going to need to come out so that it doesn't get caught in your process, as well as other stuff we can't. So why it's important, here are two different pictures of contaminants that made it all the way through that were found in some part of the process, not on the screen. And so that can cause breakages of parts and create a lot of issues. And so your screens, they're kind of out of sight, out of mind, and really just need to be in part of your preventative maintenance program. So making sure that you have a detailed checklist, including your screens in that part of your daily check. So when you're inspecting your screens, you're gonna look like this picture on the right. You can see that there's some excess gaps. It's not consistent. It's gonna allow larger particle sizes through the screens than you would prefer, which will then create issues downstream, especially if they're hard foreign objects. How to inspect when your screens are covered? It's tricky, is the short answer. Using weigh scales, if you have weigh scales on your recirculating belt, it's recirculating your screen back into your grinding circuit, can give you a slight indication, but that can be made difficult based on weather and raw material quality. There are also fancy gadgets like these thermal imaging guns. This is shooting a bearing. But you can also use that to shoot your screens and see where materials are flowing better, and it'll give you an indication as to where there are possibly hot spots on your screens. And so then what you want to do when you get a chance is check your raw material and going through and having some sort of sample screen taken out of your lab that gives you an indication, say, hey, why are we getting this oversized? And that would maybe also encourage you to then go check out your screening system. Screens, like everything else, need maintenance, right? They need to have the bearings greased. You don't want things seizing up out there. You don't want failure that's going to create issues, that's going to shut you down. And so making sure that, like we said, greasing bearings of these screens in your preventive maintenance is a good idea. Magnets and metal detectors. Some folks use magnets, some folks use metal detectors, right? Some folks just like to mag it out and pull it out. Other folks like to use metal detectors and stop it. Really your preference, but having something to capture that where possible is a good idea. In this picture, this is capturing all the oversized material coming off the screen. And so there's also some fines in there, definitely some oversized, but it gives you an indication of the health of the screening process. Are you getting too many fines indicating the screens are blinded over, or are you capturing the size that you're after? And so here's a screen deck in a brick plant. And as you can see, it's dusty, it's covered, it's difficult to see. Yeah, there's some inspection doors, but that makes it somewhat tricky, so making sure you have a good way to inspect those screens and assess the health of your screening circuit. Some folks have to run screen heaters, and you can see there's a before and an after where you're not heating the screen. It's bridging up, it's basically blinding over, and having a heated screen allows those screens to operate a whole lot more effectively. So You also have the ability to run multiple raw materials through your screening circuit, and that's both a blessing and a curse because some materials go through the screens great, other materials don't. And so you might need a multiple shaker system that allows you to get better agitation on those raw materials depending on their characteristics. Your product will tell you if you have issues with your screens or your grinding circuit or your raw material, but you'll be able to see pretty clearly on cross-section of whether or not you have too much coarse, too much fines, whether or not you're having issues with drying and firing of your product or the curing of your product is indicative of some particle size issues. If you're planning on coming to the Clemson Brick Forum, which we hope you do, it was great last year being back in person. We'll be there, all our bells and whistles, and look forward to seeing y'all. And if you're driving back through Statesville or you want to stick around today, come through, plan a tour. We'd love to see you. We'll give you a good feed and show you around. And we say it pays to use experts, right? And so especially in particle size distribution, having somebody who can help you work through that. Screening is not necessarily something that's gonna get fixed or your screening issues, but they can tell you what screens you need if you are having product issues. And so reach out to the folks at NBRC or at OPS. And as always, you can contact us at any of the below web addresses, at any of our partner locations. You can give us a call, which we always love to hear from you, or you can send us an email at asksteel@jcsteel.com, and we'll be happy to help you out. Thanks for tuning in, and be safe out there.